I was taking a trip out to L.A., tooling along in my Chevrolet, toking on a number and digging on the radio. Just as I crossed the Mississippi line, I heard that highway start to whine, and I knew that left rear tire was about to go. Well, the spare was flat, and I got up tight, cause there wasn't a filling station in sight, so I just limped on down the shoulder on the rim. I went as far as I could, and when I stopped the car, it was right in front of this little bar, kind of a redneck-looking joint called the Dewdrop Inn. Well, I stuffed my hair up under my hat and told the bartender that I had a flat, and would he be kind enough to give me change for a one? Well, there was one thing I was sure proud to see. There wasn't a soul in the place except for him and me, and he just looked disgusted and pointed toward the telephone. I called up a station down the road a ways, and he said he wasn't very busy today, and he could have somebody there in just about 10 minutes or so. He said, "Now you just stay right where you're at," and I didn't bother to tell the darn fool that I sure as hell didn't have any place else to go. I just ordered up a beer and sat down at the bar when some guy walked in and said, "Who owns this car with the peace sign and the mag wheels and four on the floor?" Well, he looked at me and I damn near died, and I decided that I'd just wait outside, so I laid a dollar on the bar and headed for the door. Just when I thought I'd get out of there with my skin, these five big dudes come strolling in with this one old drunk chick and some fellow with green teeth. And I was almost at the door when the biggest one said, "You tip your hat to this lady, son," and when I did, all that hair fell out from underneath. Now the last thing I wanted was to get in a fight in Jackson, Mississippi on a Saturday night, especially when there was three of them and only one of me. They all started laughing and I felt kind of sick. I knew I'd better think of something pretty quick, so I just reached out and kicked old Green Teeth right in the knee. Now he let out a yell that'd curl your hair, but before he could move, I grabbed me a chair and said, "Watch him, folks, cause he's a thoroughly dangerous man." Well, you may not know it, but this man's a spy. He's an undercover agent for the FBI, and he's been sent down here to infiltrate the Ku Klux Klan. He was still bent over holding on to his knee, but everybody else was looking and listening to me, and I laid it on thicker and heavier as I went. I said, "Would you believe this man has gone as far as tearing Wallace stickers off the bumpers of cars, and he voted for George McGovern for president?" "Well, he's a friend of them long-haired hippie-type pick old fags. I bet you he's even got a commie flag tacked up on the wall inside of his garage. He's a snake in the grass, I tell you guys. He may look dumb, but that's just a disguise. He's a mastermind in the ways of espionage." They all started looking real suspicious at him, and he jumped up and said, "Now just wait a minute, Jim, you know he's lying. I've been living here all of my life. I'm a faithful follower of Brother John Birch, and I belong to the Antioch Baptist Church, and I ain't even got a garage. You can call home and ask my wife." Then he started saying something about the way I was dressed, but I didn't wait around to hear the rest. I was too busy moving and hoping I didn't run out of luck. And when I hit the ground, I was making tracks, and they were just taking my car down off the jack, so I threw the man a 20 and jumped in and fired that mother up. Mario Andretti would have sure been proud of the way I was moving when I passed that crowd coming out the door and headed toward me in a trot. And I guess I should have gone ahead and run, but somehow I just couldn't resist the fun of chasing them all just once around the parking lot. Well, they're headed for their car, but I hit the gas and spun around and headed them off at the pass. I was slinging gravel and putting a ton of dust in the air. Well, I had them all out there stepping and fetching like their heads were on fire and their asses was catching, but I figured I'd better go ahead and split before the cops got there. When I hit the road, I was really wheeling, had gravel flying and rubber squealing, and I didn't slow down till I was almost to Arkansas. Well, I think I'm going to reroute my trip. I wonder if anybody'd think I'd flipped if I went to L.A. via Omaha. people say I'm no good and crazy as a loon. 'Cause I get stoned in the morning and I get drunk in the afternoon. Kinda like my old blue tick hound, I like to lay around in the shade. And I ain't got no money, but I damn sure got it made. 'Cause I ain't asking nobody for nothing if I can't get it on my own. If you don't like the way I'm living, you just leave this long-haired country boy alone. A man talking on TV, putting down the rock and roll, wants me to send a donation 'cause he's worried about my soul. He said Jesus walked on the water, and I know that it's true, but sometimes I think that preacher man would like to do a little walking too. But I ain't asking nobody for nothing if I can't get it on my own. If you don't like the way I'm living, you just leave this long-haired country boy alone.
Again. bishop sitting on a bale of hay. He ain't good looking, but he sure can play. And there's ZZ Top, and you can't forget that old brother Will is getting soaking wet. And all the good people down in Tennessee, you're digging Barefoot Jerry and CDB. Well, gather round, chill and get down. Well, you can get down, chill and get loud. Well, you can get loud, him, be proud. Well, you can be proud, him, be proud, you a rebel, cause Si's gonna do it again. Yes, it is.
Georgia, he was looking for a soul to steal. He was in a bind because he was way behind and he was willing to make a deal. When he came across this young man sawing on a fiddle and playing it hot, and the devil jumped up on a hickory stump and said, "Boy, let me tell you what. I guess you didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle player too. And if you'd care to take a dare, I'll make a bet with you. Now you play pretty good fiddle, boy, but give the devil his due. I bet a fiddle of gold against your soul because I think I'm better than you." The boy said, "My name's Johnny, and it might be a sin, but I'll take your bet and you're gonna regret, cause I'm the best as ever been." "Johnny, rosin up your bow and play your fiddle hard, cause hell's broke loose in Georgia and the devil deals the cards. And if you win, you get this shiny fiddle made of gold, but if you lose, the devil gets your soul." Opened up his case and he said, "I'll start this show." And fire flew from his fingertips as he rosined up his bow. And he pulled the bow across the strings and it made an evil hiss. And then a band of demons joined in and it sounded something like this. Finished, Johnny said, "Well, you're pretty good, old son, but sit down in that chair right there and let me show you how it's done." Fire on the mountain, run, boys, run. The devil's in the house of the rising sun. Chicken in the bread pan, picking out dough. Granny, there's your dog back, no child knows. The devil bowed his head because he knew that he'd been beat, and he laid that golden fiddle on the ground at Johnny's feet. Johnny said, "Devil, just come on back if you ever want to try again. I done told you once, you son of a bitch, I'm the best as ever been." He played, "Found a mountain, run, boy, run. Devil's in the house of the rising sun. A chicken in the bread pan, a picking out dough. Well, the eagle's been flying slow, and the flag's been flying low, and a lot of people saying that America's fixing to fall. But speaking just for me and some people from Tennessee, we got a thing or two to tell you all. This lady may have stumbled, but she ain't never failed. And if the Russians don't believe that, they can all go straight to hell. We're gonna put her feet back on the paths of righteousness, and then God bless America again. And you never did think that it ever would happen again. In America, did you? You never did think that we'd ever get together again. We're damn sure fooled you. We're walking real proud and we're talking real loud again. In America, you never did think that it ever would happen again. From the Sound up in Long Island, out to San Francisco Bay, and everything that's in between them is our home. And we may have done a little bit of fighting amongst ourselves, but you outside people best leave us alone. 'Cause we'll all stick together, and you can take that to the bank. That's the cowboys and the hippies and the rebels and the Yanks. You just go and lay your hand on a Pittsburgh Steelers fan, and I think you're gonna finally understand. And you never did think that it ever would happen again. In America, did you? You never did think that we'd ever get together again. We damn sure fooled you. We're walking real proud and we're talking real loud again. In America, you never did think that it ever would happen again.
There was only one place I was sure when I was still in Saigon. Saigon.
Try to sit down and talk to her, it always end up in a fuss. I tried to reason with her right up till the time that she got on that Greyhound bus. It'd be better if I could forget her, cause she sure forgot about me. And if it takes all night, I'm gonna do it right. I'm gonna sit here till I can't see.
Well, I'm a-sittin' on the bar stool, acting like a darn fool. That's what I'm a-doin' today.
And I'm a-sittin' here drinking, trying to keep from thinking I'm boozing my troubles away.
But now I couldn't make her stay. Well, doggone her anyways, you can't say that I didn't try.
Pour me another one, I'm finished with the other one, I'm drinking my baby goodbye.
And I'm a-sittin' on the bar stool, acting like a darn fool. That's what I'm a-doin' today.
And I'm a-sittin' here drinking, trying to keep from thinking I'm boozing my troubles away.
Pour me another one, I'm finished with the other one, I'm drinking my baby goodbye. I said to pour me another one, I'm finished with the other one, I'm drinking my baby goodbye.
Me and my buddy got us a wild hair and figured we wanted to go somewhere, so we loaded up my ragtop Chevrolet. We had a little bit of money and a whole lot of show, and with Hank Jr. blaring on the radio, we got a tank full of gas and we was on our way. We figured we'd go down to New Orleans, and we were barreling down old 17 when a man with a blinking red light was on our tail. He said, you were doing 60 and a 45, but I'm gonna let you go this time. But if I catch you again, I'm gonna slap you in the county jail. We said, thank you, sir. You sure been nice, and you ain't gonna have to tell us twice that we were southbound and down with the wind blowing in our faces. We kept on rolling, and pretty soon the radio was cooking out a haggard tune, and we were pulling into Houston and checking out all them places. I was feeling dry and I said, I think we ought to stop and get ourselves a drink. Old Jim said, yeah, 'cause we got time to kill. We kept kept on rolling, I seen this spot. We pulled into the parking lot of this place called the Cloud Nine Bar and Grill. We walked through the door and the place was jammed. The lights were low, they had a punk rock band and some orange-haired feller singing about suicide. I said, Jim, this ain't our kind of place. He said, well, let's just have one round anyway. So against my better judgment, we walked on inside. Went up to the bar, we sat down. This feller walked up and said, I'll buy this round. And he sat down on a bar stool next to Jim. He looked like a girl, but he talked like a guy. Had lipstick on and mascara in his eye. And everybody in that place looked just about like him. I said, Jim, this ain't our kind of bar. Let's just go on out and get back in the car, cause it's gonna be trouble. Ain't no sense in taking a chance. We was getting up, getting ready to leave. Somebody grabbed old Jim by the sleeve. It was this good-looking girl. She was asking my buddy to dance. I said, Jim, don't do it. There's something missing. There's fellas dancing and fellas kissing. There's a fella in a high-heeled shoes wearing pantyhose. He said, partner, I just can't turn this down. You just go over there and have one more round. I'll dance with the lady and we'll get on down the road. So he walked away and left me alone. And this funny looking fella kept coming on. And he was making me mad at some of the things he said. And then he put his hand on my knee. I said, if you don't get your paw off me, I'm gonna locate your nose around on the side of your head. He said, I love it when you get that fire in your eye. I said, well, partner, try this on for size. And I unloaded on him. He went out like a light. Everybody in that place must have been his friend. They all headed for me. I said, this is the end, but where I come from, we don't give up without a fight. They were screaming and yelling and scratching and clawing. I was punching and hitting and kicking and pawing. I was holding my own because I've been in a scrap or two. Old Jim come running up out of the blue, and that gal he was with come running up too and proceeded to beat on me with a high-heeled shoe. I grabbed her by the hair and come off in my hand, and that beautiful girl was just a beautiful man. Old Jim just got sick right there on the floor. He dropped that dude like a shot from a gun, smeared his lipstick, made his makeup run, and me and old Jim started fighting our way to the door. Man, we let out of there in that Chevrolet, and I put her on the floor and she stayed that way. We was going down the highway doing about 110. We was headed for home and we was getting near, and then a red light come on in the rear view mirror, and that same blame cop was pulling us over again. Well, I'm sitting here in this county jail. I had to call my daddy to go our bail, but I learned me a lesson that I never will forget again. I done give up drinking, I've give up bars, and running around the country in souped up cars, going back where the women are women and the men are men.
Cause I'm gonna put some fire on the string. And if you boys got their rocky boogie woogie little country blues.
A country blues.
Call me a redneck, a reckon that I am, but this thing's going on, make me mad down to the core. I have to work like a dog to make ends meet. There's crooked politicians and crime in the street, and I'm madder than hell, and I ain't gonna take it no more. We tell our kids to just say no, and then some panty-waist judge lets a drug dealer go. He slaps him on the wrist and he turns it back out on the town. But if I had my way with people selling dope, I'd take a big tall tree and a short piece of rope. I'd hang them up behind a little swing till the sun goes down. Well, you know what's wrong with the world today? People done gone, put their Bibles away. They're living by the law of the jungle, not the law of the land. Well, the good book says it, so I know it's the truth. An eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. You better watch where you go and remember where you've been. That's the way I see it, I'm a simple man. Now, I'm the kind of man wouldn't harm a mouse, but if I catch somebody breaking in my house, I got a 12-gauge shotgun waiting on the other side. Don't go pushing me against my will. I don't want to have to fight you, but a darn sure will. If you don't want trouble, then you better just pass me on by. As far as I'm concerned, there ain't no excuse for the raping and the killing and the child abuse. I got a way to put an end to all that mess. You just take them rascals out in the swamp. Put them on their knees and tie them to a stump. Let the rattlers and the bugs and the alligators do the rest. Well, you know what's wrong with the world today. People done gone, put their Bibles away. They're living by the law of the jungle, not the law of the land. Well, the good book says it, so I know it's the truth. An eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. You better watch where you go and remember where you've been. That's the way I see it, I'm a simple man. Watch where you go and remember where you've been. That's the way I see it, I'm a simple man.